I'm Mark Elliott, sitting in for Casey Kasem. And now we're up to the number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40. And it's by a superstar who used to be a model, a career that got started by accident. Modeling was the furthest thing from her mind as a young girl growing up in northern New Jersey. She had her heart set on being a singer. But those plans were temporarily derailed one day when she was 16, walking with her mother in the Carnegie Hall building in New York. Even at that age, the teenager was already a statuesque beauty, and her looks drew attention. Well, she and her mom were going about their business when a stranger walked up. He wanted to know if the 16-year-old was a model. She said no. Then the man asked if she wanted to be one. The teenager had never given it much thought, and she told the man so. But he refused to be discouraged. He told her about a modeling agency on the fourth floor of that building. "They're looking for someone like you," he said. "You'd be great for them." Well, the 16-year-old and her mother were very skeptical. They knew that often shifty people claim they're with modeling agencies, but it's really just a con. But the young singer and her mom decided it wouldn't do any harm just to go upstairs and find out if the man was telling the truth. As it turned out, he was. Not only was the modeling agency on the up and up, but when the executives got one look at the statuesque 16-year-old, they signed her on the spot. That accidental beginning was the start of a lucrative career as a model, a career that led to layouts in such magazines as Cosmopolitan, 17, Glamour, and Essence. And that singer might still be modeling today, but eventually her other career intervened. That career started not when a stranger accidentally saw her face, but when a record company executive heard her voice. He, too, signed her up. And as successful as she'd been as a model, she's had even more success as a singer, setting numerous chart records and scoring 8 number ones, including the song that for the second week in a row is the biggest hit in the land. The number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40 is All the Man That I Need by former model Whitney Houston.
Number 12. Holding steady this week as a singer who's had 8 number ones and now has plans to act in her first movie. She's Whitney Houston, and in November, after her current tour is over, she'll start shooting a film called Bodyguard, co-starring with this year's big Oscar winner, Kevin Costner. Here's Whitney Houston with Miracle.
How could I throw away Casey Kasem, coast to coast?
Falling 13 notches to number 39, here's Whitney Houston, whose close friend, comedian Eddie Murphy, knows what puppy love is all about. When one of Whitney's beloved Siberian huskies died, Eddie sent over an 8-week-old husky puppy to pick up her spirits. Well, this week, Whitney's got something else to pick up her spirits, the success of her 14th Top 40 hit.
Casey's biggest hit.
7 years ago this week, back in 1985, one of the biggest hits in the USA was by a superstar who this past summer became Mrs. Bobby Brown in a million-dollar wedding ceremony. The wedding took place at the new Mrs. Brown's huge estate in Mendham, New Jersey, and it was a wedding fit for a princess or a queen. The bride wore a $50,000 white lace dress that took 6 months to make. There were 700 guests at the wedding who arrived in a fleet of 80 limousines. Friends like Gloria Estefan, Gladys Knight, Patti LaBelle, Aretha Franklin, and Stevie Wonder showed up to wish the couple well and to nibble on the 10-foot-tall wedding cake. After the wedding, Mr. and Mrs. Brown went off to spend 2 romantic weeks on a yacht cruising the Mediterranean. 7 years ago this week, the new Mrs. Bobby Brown had one of the biggest hits in the USA. Here's Whitney Houston Brown with Saving All My Love for You.
Casey's Top 40.
And that means we're up to the number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40. And it's by a superstar whose number one priority is children. She's a 29-year-old singer and actress who's currently expecting her first child. And she considers that a great and wonderful blessing. You see, she's always loved children. She grew up in a family with lots of kids, a very close family. And they've stayed that way, even in music. Her brother Michael is her road manager, and her brother Gary is one of her backup singers. But this superstar never forgets those less fortunate than she. As early as her days as a celebrity model, she spent her spare time visiting orphanages and children's hospitals. Sometimes after seeing terminally ill children, she was so moved she would weep. When she became a superstar, she decided it was time to do even more to help children. So she founded a charitable foundation for children and put her mom, Sissy, in charge. The goal of the foundation is to help underprivileged children get an education and find a positive self-image. To do that, it trains counselors and starts programs in schools all across the country. The foundation doles out love in large portions, and so does the singer who founded it. She says, quote, "If anybody doesn't know a child is a miracle, they're not living on this planet," unquote. This week, the woman who's dedicated so much time, effort, and money to helping children find a better life is singing one of the biggest hits of her career. The song that for the fourth big week is the biggest hit in the USA. The number one song in the land on KC's Top 40 is "I Will Always Love You" by Whitney Houston.
It was just like something right out of the movies. New York Port Authority police got a tip that some big-time drug couriers they've been after for some time were scheduled to land at Kennedy International Airport. So they staked out the terminal and tailed the limo. Once the car was a safe distance from the busy airport, four police cars pulled the limo over, nine gun-waving cops stormed the car, and ordered the passengers to get out. Well, out stepped a very surprised and extremely nervous Bobby Brown and Whitney Houston. The superintendent of Port Authority Police personally called to apologize to the couple the next day.
American Top 40.
Hi, I'm Shadoe Stevens with only the biggest names here on AT40. Here's the lady who swept the American Music Awards a few weeks ago, walked away with seven of them, and the Award of Merit.
Casey's biggest hit.
A year ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was "I Have Nothing" by a woman who has plenty with her when she goes on tour. She even takes along her own dressing room, including all the furniture. We've heard about stars wanting to enjoy the comforts of home, but in the case of Whitney Houston, those comforts take up a whole moving van. During her recent worldwide tour, along with hundreds of costumes, Whitney carried along a custom-made dressing room so she'd never have to put up with bad lighting while she was getting ready to go on, and so she'd never have to sit in a chair or on a couch that wasn't really comfortable. It's that attention to detail that made Whitney Houston one of the biggest stars in the world. A singer who had one of the biggest hits in the USA a year ago this week.
Music.
Following the mega success of her big screen debut in The Bodyguard, people have been wondering what's next for Whitney Houston. Wonder no more, my friends. She's now planned to do back-to-back movies for this year. First, she's filming the adaptation of Waiting to Exhale by Terry McMillan for 20th Century Fox. And then she'll share the camera with Denzel Washington for a remake of The Bishop's Wife. The original, in 1947, starred Loretta Young, Cary Grant, and David Niven. So is Denzel, Cary Grant, or David Niven?
Casey's biggest team.
5 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was by a superstar singer and actress who says she tries to do everything she can to live a normal life. And people are so surprised to see her acting normal, they assume it isn't her. Whitney Houston says she refuses to go into the sort of semi-seclusion that too many stars have to go through. And so she makes a point of going shopping with her daughter, going to the movies with her, even going to restaurants. Whitney says she'll often see people looking at her with a confused look, wondering if she's really who they think she is. But they usually just shrug and assume that, no, there's no way that she could be Whitney Houston. Stars just don't go out in public like that. 5 years ago this week, Whitney Houston had one of the biggest hits in the USA.
Casey's Coast to Coast.